Welcome to episode 60 of the 3MFIA podcast. Welcome to Chennai, a vibrant city steeped in history and culture. Nestled on the southeastern coast of India, Chennai is renowned for its rich heritage, bustling streets, and mouth-watering cuisine. But there is something that lies within this city, and that is stories of supernatural beings. From ancient forts to abandoned mansions, Chennai is home to several haunted places that whisper stories of the past. In this episode, let's go through some of the most haunted places in Chennai. And towards the end, I would love to know which one of these would you like to visit next? Because trust me, each one is as interesting and exciting as the other. Let's get started. Hello and welcome to the 3AMFIA podcast. I'm Nikita Ferrao, mystery and thriller author. On this podcast, I talk about real crimes and real people. Due to the graphic nature of some of this content, listener discretion is advised. You can find the episode show notes on my website 3AMFIA.com. Let's get started. De Monte Colony. In a busy neighborhood in Chennai, there's a forgotten colony just off St. Mary's Road. It's not like the rest of the area, with its rundown houses and old trees casting shadows. People say it's haunted by the ghost of a rich Portuguese merchant who suffered a tragic life. The story goes something like this. There was once a wealthy Portuguese prince named John de Monte. He, along with his wife, Mary, lived in a beautiful settlement in Chennai called De Monte Colony. John owned a lot of land in fancy areas like Mowbray Garden, Greenways Road, and near the Madras Club. He was a devout Christian and a very rich man. He even built the Our Lady of Mount Carmel Church in Kollam. And in that area, he also had a weekend home. But sadly, his story took a tragic turn. His wife, Mary, got very sick with a mental illness. And their son, who was supposed to join them in India, passed away at a young age. These tragedies left John heartbroken and longing for his home in Europe. Although he was a very wealthy man, he could not escape this sorrow. As John grew old, he decided to hand over all his property to the Archdiocese of Madras. They took care of his lands and rented them out to different people over the years. But strange stories began to circulate about De Monte Colony. People whispered that the place was cursed because of all the misfortunes that had fallen on John. Rumors of ghosts haunting the area would only add to this eerie atmosphere. Locals started telling stories about doors opening and closing on their own, and even that their pets started disappearing without a trace. There was a night guard who was hired to keep watch, but he met an unfortunate end too. Some say his spirit still lingers in one of those houses, playing tricks on those who dare to enter. The scary tale became so famous that it inspired a Tamil movie in 2015, sharing the exact same name as the haunted colony. The movie story goes something like this. Four friends who were drunk decided to visit a scary old house for fun. But when one of them takes a diamond necklace from there, strange things start happening at their home, making it seem as if it's haunted. IMDb rated this movie 7 out of 10. Broken Bridge in Besan Nagar. This bridge is a curious sight to see. Now you would think, what does a broken bridge have to do with haunting? Now this bridge seems like it leads to nowhere. Originally, it was meant to help fishermen to cross over. Because it couldn't withstand the harsh waves, it eventually collapsed. But that's not the end of the story. Locals say that the broken bridge has become a hotspot for strange occurrences. Fishermen claim to hear eerie screams late at night, believing that they are the cries of a woman who was attacked and assaulted there. Even more disturbing, there were unidentified bodies that were found near the bridge. And how they got there or who did this to them is unknown to this day. Now, despite the horrible condition of the bridge, it keeps drawing people there. It's not only about the chilling mystery that surrounds it, but also its beauty. Blue Cross Road. During the daytime, this road may seem peaceful and ordinary, with a school on one side and an old animal welfare center on the other. But as the sun sets, locals swear the atmosphere changes dramatically. Despite its seemingly mundane surroundings, this place has earned a reputation for paranormal activity. Reports say that this place is a suicide hotspot in Chennai. And that's why there are so many occurrences, scary, eerie occurrences surrounding it. Now, if you are walking around this road, people say that there is a very high chance that you could be meeting some spirits here. There are rumors about ghostly apparitions haunting the road. And because there were so many suicides that happened here, people are not surprised. The dense trees lining the road only add to the scary atmosphere. Once the night falls, the road transforms into a place that no one wants to visit. People have claimed to have seen this pale white figures darting through the streets, sending shivers down their spine. Some even say that they felt the sudden sharp slap on their face, and when they turned, no one was there. So who slapped them? This is your chilling reminder to know that ghosts just don't roam around old abandoned houses. They could also be there in open roads. Karikattu Kuppam. This seaside location, home to mostly fishermen, has been haunted by fear ever since the tsunami struck Chennai in 2014. Now no one could forget what happened, the tragedy that happened at that time. Known as the Death District for its tragic history, this area is littered with debris and ruined homes, sending shivers down the spines of those who visit. Locals believe that the spirits of the unfortunate victims of the tsunami still linger here, unable to find peace. Even the fishermen who were lucky enough to survive have left this place. Walking through this location, you'll still find reminders of the disaster all around you. Toys, footwear, clothes, all left behind in the wake of the waves. It's a place where the memory of the tragedy is always around you. You can see it in the broken, torn-down houses and empty streets. It is said that when people visited the temple here early in the morning, they had seen blood drops. After the tsunami disaster, so many body parts have floated on to this place that no one has been able to live here. The tsunami had taken away so many lives that this place may not see happiness for a very long time again. Theosophical Society. At the heart of the Theosophical Society, a renowned museum established in 1882, stands a majestic 450-year-old banyan tree. But this ancient tree isn't just a symbol of age and wisdom. It is the center for a spine-chilling haunting. As night falls, the atmosphere around this tree takes on a sinister vibe. There is a forest surrounding this tree that does not make it any easier. People have said that they have heard strange sounds like screams and someone calling out their name. According to a local legend, the tree is not just a simple tree, but a place for ghosts and witches. So much so that the night watchman has given strict orders that no one should visit this place after sunset. Now, while the banyan tree might seem like a perfect spot to take your Instagram photo, people are widely advised to not stay after sunset. And those who have ever broken this rule and tried to stay, they have always said that they felt that someone was there watching them. Madras Christian College. Madras Christian College, or MCC, typically is a vibrant college campus. But this place has a darker side, according to local legend. It is said that the grounds are plagued by paranormal activity, all from the spirit of a jilted lover. The story goes that a young man, unable to bear the pain of rejection from the woman that he loved, took his own life in the campus. And since then, his spirit is said to roam the halls, particularly Heber's Hall and the zoology wing of the college. Students have reported hearing mysterious sounds, breaking glass, and objects suddenly falling without anyone touching them. Some have even claimed that they have heard the echoes of his footsteps in empty corridors. There are so many other mysterious things that have happened in the campus that no one could explain, such as taps turning on by themselves, utensils clinging together, and the windows cracking. Even more disturbing, some people have fallen sick and have even experienced bruises without anyone hitting or hurting them. Some have also claimed that they have felt as if they were hallucinating. Who knew that a hurt lover could leave such a huge mark in history? F2 at Valmiki Nagar. In Valmiki Nagar, just 15 kilometers from Chennai Airport, sits a house on Ambedkar Road that's famous for being one of the most haunted places in Chennai. It's owned by the father of a woman who tragically took her own life there. From the past decade since her death, the house has been shrouded in scary stories. Strange things happened at this house. People say that they have seen the ghost of the daughter who still lingers in there. She supposedly opens the doors for visitors after midnight and even treats them well. That's one good ghost. Some folks claim that they have heard the sound of a girl crying from inside the house. And when they pass by, their mobile phones start losing signal. And they even start acting up, like their screens start flickering. Others even say that they have seen the girl itself. Now, what's surprising here is that Google marked this house as haunted in its map. And that's why this place is one of the most popular haunted places in Chennai. Wipro, CDC 5. Even in the bustling world of technology, Chennai's spooky stories find a home. Surprisingly, the Wipro Technology Park has become an unexpected hotspot for paranormal activity. Rumors of a shadowy figure haunting the premises and sometimes even mingling among the tech-savvy staff. But what's truly shocking is the whispered tale that the Wipro campus was unknowingly built on top of a cemetery from the 1980s. Reports from the night guards add fuel to this chilling rumors. It is said that they have seen some scary stuff here. Visitors are warned to stay away after dark, as even a brief meeting with this mysterious figure can leave them feeling feverish, shivery, or even be physically harmed. East Coast Road. East Coast Road, or ECR, is known for its scenic drive. It is dotted with water parks and amusement rides, and during the day, it's the favorite among those who want to take a long drive. But as night falls, this drive turns into a ghost drive. Stories about paranormal activities have led many to dub this place as a highway to hell. Drivers, whether sober or not, have said that they have seen something, and that has caused them to swerve away from the road, sometimes meeting a fatal accident. It's kind of something that you see in these horror movies. A person is driving on a quiet, empty road, and suddenly someone comes in front. The driver tries to swerve away, only leading to an accident. And that's exactly why this road is called Highway to Hell. Now, these ghostly figures are not just any ghostly figures. People have said that they have seen toddlers and young girls crossing the road at night. This confuses the driver, which causes accidents. Despite its haunting reputation, travelers still brave enough want to visit this place because it leads to destinations that are popular holiday getaways. So this road is a perfect road for them to travel. But for those who dare to drive by this road, they are being cautioned. Anna Flyover. Right in the middle of the city, close to the busy Mount Road, there's Anna Flyover. But this isn't just any bridge, it's surrounded by haunting stories. Despite being near the St. Thomas National Shrine, visitors have reported strange things happening here. There's a half-built building nearby, and rumor has it that it's haunted by the ghost of people who took their own lives there. Passerbys have heard eerie sounds like crying and laughing coming from the flyover. Even when it's hot outside, some people have said that they have felt an icy chill on their body. That's enough to scare anyone. On hot summer nights, people have said that they have felt cold, which is quite weird and scary at the same time. Victoria Hostel Road. Behind the bustling Chepauk Stadium, there's a quiet road called Victoria Hostel Road. But instead of being peaceful, it was filled with eerie whispers and spooky trees. Back in the 1800s, a hostel was built there for college students. But over time, strange things started happening. People reported seeing and feeling ghostly encounters along the road. It got so bad that the hostel had to be abandoned because of all these paranormal incidents. Even now, those who are brave enough to visit there said that they could feel goosebumps or that someone was watching them. The hostel's scary reputation led to everyone leaving, but the haunting memories are still there. Would you ever dare to visit this place? Besant Avenue Road. A once beautiful road has now become famous for its ghostly encounters. Travelers, especially those riding two-wheelers, started experiencing strange things while passing through. People began feeling uneasy and cold while driving along this road. Some have even seen or felt things that they couldn't explain. These incidents made traveling on Besant Avenue Road a real challenge for the residents, both during the day and night. It is said that there is a ghost there, and that ghost is not a friendly one. The ghost is known for being violent, slapping people who pass by, and that has caused people to be thrown off from their vehicle, especially motorbikes. And what's even scarier is that people could hear this laughing sound after they have been attacked. Many have reported these strange incidents to the local police station. Some have even fainted because of the force of the slap, while others, including children, have been thrown off the vehicle. But unfortunately, even the police couldn't do anything because no one saw anything. No one knows exactly why these strange things are happening, but one thing is for sure. It's better to avoid the street altogether. Although Chennai has its own fair share of haunted places, it also has some very beautiful places. And I would highly recommend, if you're planning a visit to Chennai, visit its beautiful places, visit its historical places, and don't miss out on the haunted places, but only during daytime and with someone. And if you have already been to Chennai and if you have visited any of these places, I would really love to know, have you experienced something? A big thank you to all my fellow listeners who have been listening to all my episodes. Thank you so much. Your listens, your support means a lot. If you love my podcast, if you love the stories that I put out, then please do follow me on whichever podcasting platform you are listening from. And please do leave a rating. It will really help me a lot. You can listen to me on other platforms, including Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and any other podcasting platform. If you are in India, you can always listen to my podcast on Gaana or JioSaavn. If you love to listen to strange and mysterious stories, then follow me on Instagram and YouTube, where I put out reels on such stories. These are completely different from the ones that I put out on my podcast, so do follow me on them. If you love travel, you can follow me on my travel channels. I'll link them also in the description. Until then, stay kind and stay safe out there.